I'm just going to show you how to create a target range for a sparkline chart. If you're familiar with sparkline charts, they are little mini charts that you can put within the cell of your worksheet. So you can create a chart out of this and just have it as a different chart element, but these particular charts are in line to the cell. You can notice that this takes up cell I-15, this one is J-15, etc. Now, they're actually pretty easy to make, these sparkline charts. They actually are a concept that Edward Tufte came up with. And these are little line charts here. The thing about sparkline charts is there are some limits in terms of what you can do. And one of the limits is to kind of create a target range. So for example, I have created a little target range here. This is 30 to 45%. You can see these are percentages. And this particular type of implementation of a target range lends itself easier when you have certain numbers that make it easier, such as percentages. 0 to 100%, it's kind of easier to put something like this together. Now, when you have really wide ranging values, it might not be as good, but let's get into see how we create something like this. I'm just gonna go into a cell here and start to create my sparkline. Go to Insert, and under the Sparklines group, I'm gonna create a column chart first. And the reason why I'm creating a column chart first is it makes it a little bit easier to identify the low and high of the range. So when I click on that, it's gonna ask me what my data range is. I'm going to select that for my data range. My location range is, I already selected that cell. I picked up my location range. I might want to increase it to include a range of 5 cells. Let's click on that and let's pull it out to my 5 cells. One row, 5 cells, 1R times 5C, one row, 5 columns. All right, so I click that, go back here and click OK. And now we have our beginnings of our sparkline, even though this is a column and I'm doing a line chart. I am going to make that a little wider and probably make that a little bit wider here, just for now. Make this probably 150 some odd pixels for now. We'll have to adjust it later on. So in terms of what we want to get at, we want to get at a view that is kind of where our labels kind of fit everything so far before we start to put in the range. So usually in sparkline charts, there's really not a good labeling scheme. You have to put your own labels there. And it's not like creating a line chart where you can do the labeling for X and Y axis. This is kind of a little more simplified when you think about creating it. So we're gonna have to create labels outside of the sparkline chart. We know that there are 9 rows or 9 weeks, so I can kind of use a combination of spaces between numbers and font sizes to create this. So I just type 1, space 2, space 3, space 4, space 5, space 6, space 7, space 8, space 9. Press enter, and you notice it doesn't seem to line up to my columns right. So I'm going to pick out a font that is a fixed width font that makes it a bit easier to do. So Courier is usually a pretty good fixed font. Let's make the font size a little smaller too. Maybe 9 would be okay. Double click to auto fit. And it seems like it's okay so far. And also do a word wrap. Let's see, maybe word wrap didn't do it. I think maybe we will center it. So we centered it and it looks actually pretty good. Take that, Control C to copy. Bring it to my other areas below the sparklines. Control V to paste. And select those columns, double click to auto fit, and let's see if we got them pretty much. Yep, so it looks pretty good. So we have our numbers underneath each one of the columns, so it kind of fits it kind of nicely. And for here, we know that this is percentage, so we need to make that probably from 0 to 100%. So 100 is going to be on the top and 0 is going to be on the bottom. I'm going to type 100%, and I'm going to need to put a couple line feeds in there using the Alt Enter key. 5 will do, I think. Then type 0, press Enter, and see where that happens, where we can fit that. Ooh, that wasn't too good. Click the drop down here and I'll start to remove some of the line feeds and see if it picked it up. Yep, so that looks good. Let's right align that, and we have our areas there. So now we've got a good idea of the aspect we want our spark lines to be in. If this is kind of our final sizing that we want, that's good. And we can start to put in our range. If our range was between, let's say a range between 30 and 50%, what we need to do, I always would like to do this, is take a copy of this, Control C to copy, Control V to paste, and just put that out down there so we don't mess up our data. And from here, what I need to do is just change something here. Change it to 0.3, and maybe change this to 0.5. So we have a area where we can start to put our range in. Now, this is going to be something where we just need to insert a shape. Go to Insert, go to Shape, and I'm going to insert this rectangular shape. I'm going to pull it in here and pull it out. All right, so I'm going to draw my shape there. A good idea is also to increase the zoom size so we get a better view of it. And let's see how that looks. And we need to have it get up to the 40 a little bit more. And that looks okay. So the combination of using your mouse button and using the shift key, pressing the shift key, makes it a little bit easier to fine-tune the placement of the shape. Let me spread this out a little bit more. All right, and when you press the Alt key, it will click into the grid. So you can see that it clicked into the grid here over to the right in column M. Let's see when I press my Alt key and see if it clicked to the grid here. So it did. So now we want to change the color scheme here. Earlier I had something like an orange. Let's stick with that. Let's click orange here. We're shape filled with orange. We don't need to have the shape outline. I don't need that. But the thing about the shape fill is this color overtakes the bars here. So I want to make that a little bit transparent. Go to shape fill, click the drop down, go to more fill colors, and what we want to do is change the transparency. Let's make it a little bit more transparent. Maybe 70%. Click OK. Let's see what happens there. And that looks actually okay. So we have 70% transparency. Maybe that was a little bit too much. Maybe 60%. Let's go back to the shape fill. Go to more fill colors. And let's change this to 60. Press 60. Press enter. And that looks okay. So now we have our chart here that looks like it's going from 30%. Let's make this a little bit, go back to 100%, right? So this is 30 to 50%. But one thing you'll notice, so here we're going to have a little bit problem, because what Excel does is it based the sizing of the columns on the individual data. So what does that mean? Let's say, for example, I change all this data to, 0.2. Type point, select everything here. Press 0.2, press Control Enter to enter 0.2 for everything. And now you notice everything is 0.2. So 0.2 is the maximum, right? And so that particular target range does not look right. What we need to do is we need to change the axis to span across all of these charts. So I'll select this, go to Design, and under the group, go into Axis, and we want to have the vertical axis minimum and maximums all the same, right? So click the same for the minimum, click the same for the maximum, and now we've got the correct sizing, right? So now that looks like it's all 20%. It's under our 30% here, and so that fixes that. And now all I need to do is bring back my data here, since I've taken care of those minor tweaks. Take this, Control C to copy, or Control X to cut. I don't want that down there anymore. Go back up here, go to here, Control V to paste. Whoops, my data is gone, because I think when I put that data down there, the source of this probably was in cell, the rows 18, 19, 20. Let's change this back. Go to Design, go to Edit Data. Let's see where, oh yeah, the date range disappeared. Let's just take care of that right now. and have it B2 to F10. Press enter, and my data shows back up, right? So now, hopefully, also my configuration for my axis is saved. If it's not, yep, it's the same for all Sparklines, that's saved, so that's good. So, just to look, make sure that I have everything I need, let's see, week 6 in test 1, well, let me bring this over first. Control C to copy, and then Control V to paste. And week 6 of test 1 is 0.17, that looks good. Let's see if the other ones kind of pan out. Test 2, week 2, 0.39, that is in that range. So I've created a Sparkline range here. You can see that I created it with the column chart first, and it just made it easier to see where the 0.3, as I said before, we're going from 30 to 50%, and it just made it easier to make that particular text box to go from 0.3 to 0.5, 30 to 50%. I can go back here into my design tab under the Sparkline tools and now change that to a line, and we have our line chart. Now this particular type of chart also looks like an upper bound and lower bound type of range for a line chart, and that's something very similar in statistics or operations type of visualizations, but this is something that you can do with a Sparkline. And earlier I had it where the particular range, we also kind of gave it a label, so I'll probably do it here too. Let's press the shift key and kind of move this out here, and then I just need to put a text box. Go to insert, text box, and I'll just put 30 to 50 here. And I have to make the font size a little bit smaller. 30 to 50%. Control A to select everything. Let's make it a little bit smaller. Maybe I need to make that box a little bit bigger so I can fit it. All right, and pull this up here. And for that box, let's center everything. And let's see what happens. Now we also want to have that text box a little bit blend into my range. So I selected that text box, go into format, and for the shape fill, no fill, and also no outline for the box. So now it kind of blends in really nicely here. If I also wanted to make this a little bit more presentable, let's put some borders around here. Let's put some borders on this portion of it. You can go select that, go under the font group, put some borders there, put some borders there, and let's put a text here, week, and then control enter. Whoops, let's make that left aligned and also put a border there and center that. Click on center here and let's get rid of the grid lines, go into view, get rid of the grid lines, and make that a little bit colorful. Let's make this a blue. Earlier I had that as an orange. Go under cell styles, you make that a blue, and maybe I'll put my range, my source data here, put that in grid lines too. Now we have our Sparkline charts with a target range, 30-50% here, and it gives us an idea of where we want to see our data within a certain range. So I hope that helps. Thanks for watching.